some groups of vulnerable young people who can't meet up with friends and who could be deprived of vital services in the long term. Charities are warning that a quarter of youth groups could struggle to reopen after the lockdown has ended. Anna Adams reports.
Normally, you'd have 30 to 50 young people here after school and holidays.
Mervyn Kay is showing me around the Dunk Youth Club in Lewisham, South London. It's been closed since the lockdown. In what ways are you having to change the way you work?
Trying to meet the young people where they are. So we're using TikTok, we're using Instagram. We're basically trying to recreate the youth club and adventure playground experience as best we can in a virtual environment.
Nicola is a youth worker. She's chatting online with kids who would normally be here. And how do you feel if you're not able to come here for 3 months? Well, this club is confident that it will survive the difficult months ahead, but others across the country are worried about the knock-on effect of coronavirus and the lockdown and what that will do to the young people who've come to rely on places like this. The National Body for Youth Workers says it's already getting reports of some young people feeling suicidal and self-harming.
We're seeing an awful lot of services closed and not being able to reopen and provide that vital support. There are a million young people with hidden needs that just aren't being supported today.
Charities say more than 20% of youth services will not survive.
Some more, baby. Do you want some more? Some more, baby.
Youth workers in North London are out looking for some of the teenagers they've lost
contact with. You've gone all gooey, haven't you? Oh, gooey, baby.
Young people who have been involved in criminal activity or,
you said budgies don't make good dogs, huh? Budgies make great dogs. Oh, they do. Look at you having your tickles. Oh, that nice. That nice, baby.
No one knows how long this lockdown will last. Anna Adams, BBC News, St Albans. Well, we're expecting...
Yeah, I love you too.
...from the UK government.
I do love you too.
In the meantime, our political correspondent Ben Wright is here. Ben, every day this crisis throws up new issues. What do you expect to be top of the list of questions today?
Right in the backdrop, which is a surging death toll, sadly, still in the UK. A couple of hours ago, we found out there were 917 new coronavirus-related hospital deaths in the UK over the last 24 hours, bringing the total to 9,875. So today's total is slightly lower than yesterday, but still a huge number, and still a huge trauma for many families across the country. I'm sure that will be part of the questioning when this press conference happens. What else is around today? I think yesterday we saw Matthew Hancock, the health secretary, tried to get onto the front foot on the issue of protective